Welcome to Suzanne's studio, and I'm Suzanne. As usual, I do have some really interesting, talented, hot guests. Well, wait till you hear the program today. I am so excited to have you meet the following: George Orbelian, is that right?
Thank you.
And his darling wife, Marcia, and Dr. Blasband.
Excellent.
Let's start with you, Dick. Just for a moment, we're going to talk about Nikolai Levachov. Nikolai is a Russian healer. He's now living in Moscow. I have interviewed him 3 times, and he is, first of all, he's a genius. I just totally think that the audience is just going to really, really enjoy this program. And now that I have these 3 hot guests, you'll really get the dirt. Okay, Dick, how did you become interested in Nikolai?
Well, I had just come from doing some research with some people at the Princeton University Engineering Anomalies Research Laboratory. And they were studying stuff like the ability for one person to know what another person was seeing. Mm-hmm. At sometimes 10, 20, even thousands of miles away without any kind of no known form of communication. And they also studying the ability of people to influence machines like random number generators and things like that with their mind alone. And they had demonstrated unequivocally that these things were possible by ordinary people. So with that in my mind, working out here in California, a student of mine told me about Nikolai, and at the time I had chronic fatigue syndrome, and no one could really help me with it, so I went to see him, and I knew that within minutes that this man had tremendous powers, because I had been exposed to famous healers prior to this, people who were known worldwide, and whom friends of mine had done research upon. But none of them really had the capacity of Nikolai. And by the way, it should be mentioned that Nikolai is also a theoretical physicist of a very high caliber. And he came to know his own abilities through the use of using his mind upon reflecting on what he did and what its impact was on other people, and using the scientific method to find out how he was able to do the extraordinary things that he does. So I began work with Nikolai as one of his clients. And when I heard that he was going to hold a class, I thought, well, that would be an interesting thing to do. Because I had referred many patients of my own, I'm a psychiatrist, to him. These were people who had heart problems and the like. And I noticed that not only were their heart problems rapidly getting better, but that they were moving much more rapidly in therapy. And these were people I'd known for several years at least. So it was easy for me to gauge that movement. And I thought, well, I would really like to be able to do this myself, to offer this to my own patients. So I took a class with Nikolai. I think it was the second class he offered. And at the end of that time, it was 6 weeks, every night during the week, I was able to heal in a rudimentary way, whereas prior to that time, I had no capacity that I knew of to do the kinds of things that I was now capable of doing.
Thank you. Marcia.
How did I come to know Nikolai?
Yeah.
He was invited to come to this country by my mother-in-law, my husband George's mother, and it just happened that he ended up staying with us when he first came here. He had no place to stay arranged. So when he was in our house, I got to know him very well. And because of that association, I was able to interact with him. And he was able to help me with some personal health problems. And they were much more serious than I realized. And that experience of having him help me was unbelievable, because I was in a state of so low, my health was so low that I wasn't enjoying life very much, and it was impacting the quality of my life tremendously. So it took time, it wasn't instant, but it went through major, major changes, and I have to say, even though it may sound weird to many people, that I feel I would not be here today if it weren't for the fact that Nikolai was able to help me with my health problems.
Thank you, Marcia, mm-hmm. and George.
Well, when Marcia and I were married, shortly thereafter we had twin boys. And in about 1990, when the boys were four, my mom had been pained by a bad leg and hip. And being a doctor trained in Russia, she knew that she would be healed in Russia ultimately. And she was introduced on a business trip with my father to Nikolai. And in one session, he was able to help her walk normally. And she stayed on with my brother, who lives in Moscow, was conductor of the Moscow Chamber Orchestra. And she would call Marcia and I at 3 or 4 in the morning because of the time change and say, George, you have to meet this guy, Nikolai. He knows so much, and you're going to just love him when you meet him. And it's really exciting. And we're staying up late and talking. And she was so excited about it that I said, well, you know, Mom, there's no way we're going over there with the twins, with Perestroika going on and all of that. And I go, so invite him to come here. And she did, and we met him. And I picked him up at the airport on New Year's Eve. And as we were driving home, I asked Nikolai in Russian, I said, Nikolai, what is it that you do? How do you heal people? How do you help people? And he told me in Russian, you know, that he regenerates tissue. Well, in Russian, the word for regeneration is regenerация. It's very close to the word in English. And so then I asked him, I go, well, how do you do that? And he goes, well, that's a longer story. And that's yeah. that's how I started working with Nikolai. From that moment on, I was hooked. I wanted to find out how he did it.
And how long did you all, how many years were you students of Nikolai's?
I'm still a student.
You're still a student. And do you call him?
Yes.
And he can really help you on the phone?
Yes, and he's taught us a lot. Actually, Dick and I worked with him on helping edit the English version of his first book, The Final Appeal to Mankind, and we took courses from him, and it was just, it's been an extraordinary experience that changed my life.
How has it changed your life, George?
Oh, in a number of ways. I'm very mechanical in the way I approach things. I used to build racing motorcycles. I wrote a book on surfboard design. And in every one of the disciplines I've approached, I wanted to understand why. How does it work? What's the system involved? And Nikolai was the first person that I came across that really explained everything. And I have to say that in 15 years of asking him thousands of questions, there was never a time when he backpedaled, changed his story, everything dovetailed, you know, from the beginning of how creation occurred and what life is and how life is an actual part of ecosystem development on planets, and that there's billions of planets with life on them, and what the spirit is and the difference between living and non-living matter, and all so many questions that he asked me that, you know, ranged on philosophy and physics. One of his favorite quotes that he shared was, you should know geology and philosophy and everything in between.
That's pretty difficult to do. But would you say, George, that he really changed your whole persona? Your personality and your body and everything?
Yes. Yes. I used to do a lot of surfing. Mm-hmm. I still surf. I've been surfing for 35 years. And when I went surfing, I'd get out of the water. In San Francisco, it's cold water, so you're wearing a wetsuit, and I'd often be just exhausted afterwards. You'd surf for an hour and a half to 3 hours, and you'd have to eat, rest, warm up. Whereas when I went on mountain bike rides, you could ride for 3 hours and you felt energized. And so after I started working with Nikolai and translating for him, sometimes I'd walk into his house after surfing, and even though I'd showered and changed, he'd ask me, "Did you go surfing today?" And I said, "Yeah, I did." The days I went mountain bike riding, when I also showered and changed, he never asked me if I went surfing. So after that happened about three or four times, I said, "Hey, Nikolai, how come when I go surfing, you ask me if I went surfing, but when I ride my mountain bike, you don't ask me if I went surfing? Mm-hmm. How do you know?" And he goes, "Well, when you're coming up the stairs, you're dragging half the ocean with you." And I go, "What do you mean I'm dragging half the ocean with me? I took a shower, I'm clean, I had no sand on my feet." And he says, "All of the extinct life forms that were part of the evolution of life of planet Earth, that developed in the ocean, which is the birthplace of life on this planet," he goes, "they don't have physical bodies anymore. So if you go out in the water without a shield, then they attach on to your life force, and that's why you feel tired when you're out there. And when you come back in, because your body's recovering and, you know, kind of rebuilding itself." So once he told me that, I said, "Well, how do I fix it?" And he goes, "Well, you have to do a shield." I said, "Well, how do I do a shield?" He says, "Well, you visualize light in your solar plexus area. You let that light grow out through your body and push anything negative or anything disease-like out of your system. And when you feel that light going out and permeating every cell in your body, then you put a shield around that. And that can be diamonds, it can be rainbows, whatever you like, but it has a program." And I said, "Nikolai, what is that program?" And he said, "It's very simple. Nothing negative comes in. None of your life force goes out without your permission." So at that point, I knew how to do the shield. I'd go in the water surfing, and I noticed no tiredness afterwards. Wow. But also what happened was I didn't have the emotional highs and I didn't have the emotional lows that were associated with, you know, the thrill of surfing, or the parts that aren't so thrilling when you're getting hammered by surf.
Well, that's quite that's a lot of evidence. But most people don't really believe that anybody can do what Nikolai does. On one of the shows, I went to see Nikolai. I'm just crazy about him. He is so different. And he knew that I had my arm broken, and he knew right where it was in my shoulder. I've said this on the show before, but I said, "Oh, Nikolai," he said, "do you want me to do something?" I said, "Oh, no, no, no." I was just there, you know, talking to him about something else. I mean, I didn't want to impose upon him. Well, why not? Okay. So in just a few minutes, I could only raise my arm about like that. And I said, "Oh, Nikolai," I said, "I can't, you know, forget it. The doctors tell me that I'd never be able to fluff up the back of my hair or anything." So he worked on it a couple of times, you know, and he said, "How's that?" And I said, "Oh, it hurts." So he did some more. And pretty soon, it went all the way up. And I told those wretched doctors, but they said, you know, "This is just all in your mind." How can you educate people to someone like Nikolai, who's a master? He's a genius. Well, he's more than a genius, right? But how do you go about that to educate people?
Well, I think one of the things that people would have to do, say, is read his books. Because the books are created in such a way that they start with very elemental things and they build. And the other thing is that they're programmed, really, by Nikolai, so that the more you read and understand, the more you'll be able to understand later on. And in my mind, that's certainly the best way, because you have his influence actually working on the reader himself.
Are these books available readily?
No. There are some that you can get in Russia, but the ones that he wrote here were self-published. And I think he's trying to set it up so that you can get them, subscribe to them on the web. But that hasn't been achieved yet.
Oh, that would be very good.
But you can read some of his stuff in English on his website, which is levashov.info.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, levashov.info. And there you'll find exposition of some of his ideas in different languages. You just click on the British flag and you will get an American or an anglicized version.
This is what I'm so intrigued about. When I met Nikolai, I knew he was really different. I mean, really different. And my deceased husband, who was a judge, he said, you know, I don't want to go up there. I don't believe in that. I said, oh, please, please. So after about half an hour talking to Nikolai, my husband said, my God, he said, this guy is kind of believable. I mean, I never thought that George would feel that way. But the thing is, and now I believe in Nikolai, and Grace much more has loaned me the book, and I read the book every night. I mean, I haven't gotten past the introduction, but, you know, because I see all those graphs and stuff. I mean, you have to be a physicist, because he is a physicist. Why was he born that way? How was he born that way?
Well,
George?
As far as his spirit is just very evolved, and he was also knowledgeable of that fact and developed himself. He was a very serious student, and he took advantages of the educational system in Russia, which is one of the top in the world. And he really looked under every rock and asked the hard questions. And I remember a story he told when he was in school, and he was asking his biology teacher at the university level now, you know, why cells change. Why do some cells become bone tissue and some cells become neurons and some cells become, you know, the heart muscle? And, you know, the teacher tried to explain it with a simplistic explanation, and Nikolai said, you know, that's what they told us in the seventh grade. Don't you know anything more that you can give me insight with? And then the teacher said, well, don't ask me questions that only God knows the answer to. And to Nikolai, that wasn't a satisfactory answer. And he's a scientist in the truest sense of the word. He just continues to search until he has an answer that makes sense, not only as an individual point, but also about everything else fitting together with it in a system that can explain life.
So it is scientific. There is evidence. And I use the word evidence.
That's very important.
In what way? How would you explain that?
Well, it's important to understand that this is not just something which, that his science, the discoveries that he's made, some of which dovetail with what we already knew, but many which are, you know, really original, startling innovations, that this came not just spouted out of his head, some guy sitting down and, you know, making all of this up, but it was the result of, you know, years of work and of study, and as George mentioned, asking, you know, the hard questions and attempting to find the answers. And in that, he used his remarkable clairvoyant abilities to see into matter and into life in a way that most people can't, but also used, you know, scientific logic and scientific method in order to come to his conclusions. It's a vast, deep body of knowledge.
Do you think he's from another planet?
I think that that the spirits which make him up, which are part of him, probably have come from other planets. Mm-hmm. George, you may know more information about that than I do.
Well, I just think the world would be a better place if there were more spirits like his on this planet.
Yeah. Could that happen?
I think it's happening.
Do you?
Yes.
But who's learning this, George?
Nikolai's sharing his knowledge all the time with people on a telepathic level and children, and it's his plan and mission to do that. That's why the title of his book is The Final Appeal to Mankind.
He's, what is he doing now in Moscow?
He's just moved back there and getting reacquainted with old friends and family, and getting back to work building a new base there.
Grace says he goes into the hospitals and helps some of the patients, or whatever patients, I'm sure, that he has contact with.
You know, yeah. I haven't spoken to him about that in particular, so I wouldn't be able to comment.
Yeah, Grace calls him. Do you call him, Dick?
3 times a week.
Really? Mm-hmm. What do you ask him? Could you tell us something
personal? Yeah, can you fix this? Well, you see, once I was healed with the chronic fatigue, I wanted to continue working with him and have my spirit evolved, because he can do that, to the point where I become a more effective healer. So I've continued to work with him, as I said, 3 times a week, in order for him to help me do that.
Mm-hmm. Marcia, how do you use all the knowledge you have now?
Since I don't practice healing, although I've attended his classes, I try to use his knowledge to help me improve the quality of who I am, and which affects the quality of my life and people around me. Mm-hmm. And it's very important to use the knowledge I've gotten from him to make every decision in life, every minute. There's something you can be present about and conscious of that'll help you be a better person, and that moment be the best moment it can be, because we really do have that ability to affect the quality of our life and the experience we're having.
And you're a dancer and an educator?
Well, I used to dance.
But you still look like you dance.
Well, I don't know. I love to move still. Mm-hmm. And now I'm working with children.
So it does spill over, doesn't it?
Yes.
It really does. It's just hard for people to believe that. And I'm sure there are a lot of other healers that we don't know about, right? But it's so hard. You know, they think it's just a bunch of nonsense, magical stuff that, you know, self-hypnosis, that you can do it yourself. But you can't. I mean, without the aid of someone who really is a healer. Don't you agree?
Well, the important thing is to know is that you can only understand what you've been evolved to understand.
Mm.
When you were a child, I mean, there were many, many things that that adults around you understood that you could not understand. And you evolve, you change, and as you become an adult, you can now understand those things. Well, there are many different levels of evolution that a person can go through while they're here, you know, incarnate on this planet. And as you evolve yourself by one way or another, with Nikolai it's very rapid, you can understand more, and you can understand more of his stuff. There were things that he taught us as a class that it took me 10 years to understand. All of a sudden, one day, I was reading some of his material, he says, "Oh, that's what he meant by that." Mm-hmm. And the reason I couldn't understand it before was that I simply didn't have, you know, the apparatus to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure that there are many, many other things, you know, that he's written about that I don't understand now, that I may never understand, you know, before I die.
Yeah, because we're all born with a certain amount of brain power, really. Like, why are some people musicians and some people are, you know, great intellectuals? Why is that? That people are so different with our brains.
It's because the spirits are different. That's an important point.
The spirits.
Yes, that we all have a spirit.
Okay. I have a really hard question. How would you define spirit?
Well, as part of our organism as a whole, in addition to the physical body, we have what are called, classically even, etheric and astral bodies and sometimes mental bodies. And these all work in concert with each other and with the physical body in order to sustain us in life. And when we die, it's simply because there's been a detachment of the spiritual body, so to speak, from the physical body. And the spirit is all of those other bodies which are not the physical body. It's with us during our lives, and when we die, it continues to survive. That's the spirit. It's a real thing.
Well, what can I say? The last time I was with you all, I mean, I could hardly get home. It's so fascinating, and it's heavy duty, but it's just awesome. We're going to do another show the end of March, hopefully, and we're going to do a continuation. And I just wanted this show to educate the audience and to make Nikolai, God bless him, more believable. And I want to thank our great crew. We have a darling crew. Of course, they're all men except for Suzanne, so I have a lot of competition with her. And it's all volunteer. And of course, I thank all of you, and I'll see you next month. And thank you, our audience, for watching. And guess what? I can't wait to see you next time. Bye-bye.